you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Who? Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
SpongeBob SquarePants!
Absorbent and yellow and porous is he?
SpongeBob SquarePants!
If nothing can nonsense be something you wish!
Welcome to Bikini Bottom, a normally peaceful undersea sanctuary. Today it will be transformed into a theater of pure horror, wherein our little yellow friend will play the starring role.
Today is the big day. I have devised an ingenious plan to finally steal the Krabby Patty formula. And if Bikini Bottom happens to get demolished in the process, oh well. With my brand new Duplicatotron 3000, I'll clone an army of robots that will wreak mayhem and destruction at my command! One last review of the checklist. Let's see. Item number one, is Plankton a genius? Answer yes. Okay, checklist complete. Throw in the switch. Welcome, my perfectly obedient robot army. Hang on. I want to get a photo for my scrapbook. Hey, hello? What do you think you're doing? Oh, no, no, no. Wait, wait. But I'm your master! I made you! No! No! Oh, my good China!
Another perfect day playing robots and racehorses.
Yeah, only I keep getting the racehorses and the robots mixed up.
Wouldn't it be great if we had real robots to play with, Patrick? I'd name mine Robo Junior, or Zorlon, or maybe Frankie.
Yeah, these unreal robots are getting boring. Hey, what if we put the robots in here?
Oh, how shellfish of you.
It's not just any shell. It's my magic wishing shell.
Wow, that's great, Patrick.
So we put the toy robots in here.
Okay.
Then we say the magic wishing words and shake the magic wishing shell.
Okay.
Then we go to sleep, and in the morning, we'll have real robots to play with.
But, Patrick, aren't we going to say the magic wishing words?
You already did.
So, okay is the magic wishing word?
It used to be Alakazama Alabala Wisna Tikitana Fushbar Griddle Bits Von Vita Schnauzer, but I kept forgetting it.
Are you sure this'll work?
Sure. Last week, I only had one big cookie crumb, and I was really hungry. So I put my cookie crumb in the magic wishing shell, then I said the magic wishing word and shook it, and in the morning, I had lots of little cookie crumbs.
Patrick, I proclaim that tomorrow is going to be the best day ever.
Good night, SpongeBob.
Good night, Patrick.
The next morning.
Gonna play with robots, gonna play with robots, gonna play with robots, gonna play with... Whoa! Gary, did you do that?
Yeah, Gary. It sure looks like we're in a doozy of a pickle. I think I'm gonna have to learn a lot in order to fix this mess.
Meow!
What a fantastic idea! These signs will provide important tips to help me out! How do I read the signs?
Meow!
Oh, okay! Press this button to read the signs. So if I want to come back and talk to you again, just walk up to you and press this button. I'd better get started now, Gary. I think that this is going to be a very long day.
Breaking news! Bikini Bottom residents have been attacked by a raging torrent of robot horror!
so much for fixing this quietly.
Authorities are not sure who is responsible for unleashing the mechanical menaces, but they have assured us that the person is in big, big trouble.
Uh-oh.
Did I say big trouble? I meant so enormous that it's hard to comprehend trouble. We'll keep you posted as this tragic story unfolds. Tragically, we're sure.
A note from Mr. Krabs! And it even smells sweaty, just like him.
Ahoy there, SpongeBob! As a faithful crew member of the Krusty Krab, you've been, promoted to head shiny object collector.
Wow! A promotion!
That's right, a promotion! So what this here new job entails is you collecting all these shiny objects that the robots are leaving behind and bringing them to me. Now stop seahorsing around and get busy collecting.
It shines.
Ah, there's nothing like the sounds of your own neighborhood.
away, SpongeBob. You're polluting my thinking space.
Trying to steal the Krabby Patty formula again, eh, Plankton? Well, you won't get away with it.
I've got bigger fish to fry. I've got to figure out how to regain control of the chum bucket from those robots.
Where did they come from?
Where? I don't know. Not for me, though, that's for sure. They just showed up out of nowhere and started calling me rude names and throwing things. They even bent all my spoons. I love those spoons like they were my...
That's terrible.
Oh, won't you help me stop them before they bend all my forks?
Not the forks! Of course I'll help. But wait, I'm supposed to collect a whole lot of golden spatulas.
Golden spatulas, eh? SpongeBob, if you could get me back into the chum bucket, I'll give you a bucket full of golden spatulas. In your dreams.
You've got a deal.
SpongeBob, this flapping robot crisis is making the Krusty Krab lose money like a sinking ship. No money means no more Krusty Krab. No more Krusty Krab means no more fry cooking for you.
No more fry cooking?
But because you're gullible, I'm gonna help you out. And of course make a small profit in return. I've got a few golden spatulas that I'll be willing to trade to you for some of those shiny objects.
You will?
Of course. What are employers for? Besides, them shiny objects is worth lots of money. Your treasure chest's looking a bit light, boy. Do you think I've got bilge water on the brain? I ain't running a charity here. Come back when you've got enough shiny objects to trade.
It's Sean. Hey, Patrick. Nice sock.
What sock?
The one you're standing on.
Oh, that one. It's lost.
Well, if that one's lost, where are your other socks?
Well, they're more lost. A bunch of robots came through here and stole my whole sock collection. I could use some help getting them back.
Sure thing, Patrick. What are best friends for?
Okay, then. For every 10 socks you bring back to me, I'll give you a golden turkey baster.
You mean spatula?
Bless you.
Hey, SpongeBob! I just dropped by to give you a bubble hand.
Bubble buddy.
You see, you're going to need to learn some new bubble-blowing moves if you're going to journey to the ninth dimension and defeat the giant monkey man.
But all I need to do is figure out how to get rid of these robots.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I've been in the soap bottle a little too long. Where were we?
Something about new bubble moves.
Right! Press this button and you'll launch yourself straight up in the air with bubble power that defeats anything that is directly above you. Try it out!
First, those stupid robots ruined a perfectly relaxing mud bath this morning, and now you show up. Can my day get any more dreary?
I am so sorry, Squidward. Patrick and I were just playing a game and...
Oh, I correct myself. I should have known that whole robot problem involved both of you.
Squidward, I don't know what to do. How can I fix everything?
Why don't you move to another town? That should help out more than enough. Move to another town. I cracked me up. But seriously, just jump around like an idiot. That should at least make me smile. Okay, just stop jumping, will you? If you take this golden spatula, will you please go away?
See, Squidward? I knew that you could help me out. You're the best.
Don't touch me.
The rolling green hills of Jellyfish Fields, a place to experience nature at its most raw, and sometimes a bit tender from the stings.
Squidward, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay, you barnacle head. Do I look like I'm okay?
Well, your nose does look pretty big. I mean, bigger than usual because it's usually pretty big. And you look clammy. And oh my gosh, you're bald!
I've always been bald, but now I'm stung all over.
Well, according to the Jellyfisher Field Manual, severe jellyfish stings can be treated effectively by applying a thick layer of king jellyfish jelly to the affected areas. King jellyfish!
Well, I guess you're off to scale Spork Mountain and die a horrible death under the vicious tentacles of King Jellyfish. I'll stay here, balled up here in excruciating pain.
You do that! Don't worry, Squidward! I'll bring back that king jellyfish jelly for you to rub all over yourself!
Ow, so ow, did you ow, find the ow, king jelly ow, fish, yet ow.
Just my size!
Thank you.
fish today. I'm going fishing for robots. I feel like a new sponge. It shines. Gary, what's shaking?
Meow.
Wow, a bungee jump for a golden spatula. I must be in heaven.
Thank you.
Ow! You said it, Gary. And toys and mail.
What? Oh, yeah, it's that sponge kid. And now, what was I supposed to tell you?
That Patrick is surrounded by robots and needs my help.
Huh? Oh, no. I think it had something to do with massaging my feet.
Well, if massaging your feet will save Patrick, then massage I must.
Help! They're making me hit myself!
Massaging your feet isn't working. I think I'd better try a more direct approach.
By clipping my toenails?
Here I come, Patrick!
SpongeBob.
Whew! Thank goodness you're safe, Patrick.
Well, of course, SpongeBob. Why wouldn't I be?
Well, the robots and the...
Oh, yeah, I found this for you. I don't know what it is, but it looks important.
Thanks, Patrick. I tell you what, all that running around has left me pooped. Why don't you continue on for a bit?
Okay. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy.
Barnacle-head, watch where you're going!
The rock is talking to me. Oh, mighty rock, I am at your command!
Down here, you big pink lummox!
Oh, hi there, Mr. Plankton. Are you going to vaporize me today?
So very tempting.
Unfortunately, I found myself in the undesirable position of having to assist you.
I was in an undesirable position yesterday, and now my neck hurts.
Heed my words, my large future minion. Go into Jellyfish Cave. Follow the instructions on the signs that you see. At the end of the caves, you'll still be a big pink idiot, but you'll know enough to help defeat the robots and get me back into the chum bucket!
Well, then will you vaporize me?
I might spare your life so I can force you to work in my sweatshop making low-quality design and knockoff wallets.
Oh, thank you! Ouch!
away there! Squidward tells me you're looking for the king jellyfish.
Yes?
Good thing, too. That monster has been stinging all my good customers in their poop decks. I hear that you can find him up top of Old Spork Mountain here. Go hook that beast, sailor!
Oh boy, Mr. Krabs. I'll see what I can do. Mrs. Puff.
Hello, Patrick. I've got a job for you to do.
Oh, boy.
I found a golden spatula, but those robots out on the island stole it and threw it into the lake. If you can figure out how to get it back, you're welcome to it.
Sure enough, Mrs. Puff.
Well done, Patrick. You're a real star.
Can I get a cookie?
No. Tell me you haven't been driving.
Of course not, Mrs. Puff. I don't even have a license.
Oh, good. Then it was just another bad dream.
Thank you.
Gosh, everyone is trying to help out today.
Step quietly there. That king jellyfish is just up at the top of this path. Good luck. You'll need it.
Thanks, Bubble Buddy. I knew the king jellyfish was big, but who knew he had such a beautiful voice?
SpongeBob! Go, SpongeBob! Go, SpongeBob!
See, no problem. You could do anything you set your mind and your muscle to.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that feels so much better.
Anything for my best friend Squidward. Can I rub some on?
What if I just gave you this?
SpongeBob, you found some!
Now they're back home, safe where they belong.
Here's your golden back scratcher.
Spatula.
I don't speak Italian.
So, do you want to trade shiny? Alrighty then.
Downtown Bikini Bottom, once a bustling metropolis, now a debris-covered crater.
SpongeBob, the robots are destroying downtown Bikini Bottom. We have to evacuate!
All right, but it's gonna take a while to get all this dust.
Not vacuum, evacuate! We have to get everyone to safety.
Can we just load them up in the boats?
That won't do any good.
Why not?
Because the robots have taken all the steering wheels.
Couldn't we just drive in a straight line?
No, there are too many turns.
Those fiends, they've thought of everything. Never fear, Mrs. Puff, I'll get those steering wheels back.
SpongeBob, if you're involved, I always fear. But I tell you what, if you can pull this off, I'll give you a golden spatula.
How about a driver's license instead?
Nice try.
Number one in the Bikini Bottom scavenger hunt. 3 years running. Push. Ow! roll, roll, roll the sponge.
Is locked from the inside. Who would do such a thing?
Gary?
Meow?
Yes, thanks for noticing. I have been working out.
Meow.
Not done? Doesn't that mean...
Meow.
Oh, that's the entrance to the rooftops which leads to the lighthouse? Aha! Uh-huh. There's another golden spatula. I could really use that.
Meow.
What do you mean get Sandy to help me? I can get through this.
Meow, meow.
Oh, that gap looks big. Okay, I'm definitely not making that jump. How is anyone going to get across there? Uh-oh, more robots. Holy Dutchman's ghost! That gap looks impossible! And impassable! Okay, okay, I'll go get Sandy to help me out.
Power of Thunder!
push, 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 push.
There you are, boy. Someone's broken the sea needle.
That's horrible. The sea needle is the cradle of Crochet Corner.
Yes, yes it is. But what's more important is that there are tikis and shiny objects just outside the windows.
Mr. Krabs, how can you think of money at a time like this?
Easy. I just clear my mind. Money, money, money. Now listen here, boy. You know that I'll give you golden spatulas if you bring me shiny objects. But I'm going to sweeten the deal. If you can break all the tikis here at the Sea Needle, I'll give you a bonus golden spatula.
Why would I want to break the tikis, Mr. Krabs?
Because they were laughing at you and calling you funny names.
What kind of funny names?
You know, SpongeBob Butt Pants.
That's not very funny.
No. But they said your mom was ugly.
Ugly? All right, Mr. Krabs, break to my shell. You've got a deal.
Is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push.
Ultimate. Ready?
Work, boy. Here's the golden spatula, like I promised.
What's shaking?
Sandy! Boy, am I glad to see you. I need your help. My TV reception has been terrible lately. I need to have someone replace my old antenna with this shiny new one.
Yes, sir. That there antenna is shinier than a $3 bill. Well, why don't you replace it yourself?
I'm not really much of a jumper.
So, what's jumping got to do with it?
Because the old antenna is up there.
Woo! That's taller than a glass of Texas iced tea.
The robots have blocked off that building, and I can't do all those fancy moves you and SpongeBob do to get across these gaps. All I could do is flex! Wanna see?
Yeah, great. So what are you gonna do with the old antenna?
Oh, that? It's yours if you replace it with a new one.
Well, I have been getting bad TV reception in the tree dome. Okay, Larry, you got a deal.
What's happening, SpongeBob?
Hey, Larry.
Thank you.
not as good as Jackie's barbecue sauce.
Bikini Bottom Scavenger Hunt, 3 years running. Thank you.
You'll have to open this door from the inside.
SpongeBob, I'm impressed. How did you find...
Well, there were these robots. I met Sandy, and the lighthouse was...
Okay. Sorry I asked. Here's the golden spatula that I promised you.
Thanks, Mrs. Puff. Now I'll help you guys evacuate.
But SpongeBob, you don't have a driver's license.
Oh, don't I?
No, you don't.
Well, if I don't, then what's this?
A library card.
Oh.
Goo Lagoon, a sun-drenched beach of sludge at the bottom of the sea. But all is not well here on Paradise.
SpongeBob, do I look burned?
Well, you do look a little red.
Barnacles! That darn robot.
Robot?
Yeah, a big robot stole everybody's sunscreen.
Oh no, everyone will burn, and then they'll get all itchy and peel.
Exactly! You can't spend a day at the beach without sunscreen. That sun is way too hot. That robot is out on the island. Nobody can get to him. SpongeBob, maybe you can use those sun reflectors to point the sun's rays on that robot. If you hit one of the buttons on the side of a lifeguard tower, the reflector will turn. Connect all the towers and the light will shoot right out of the big reflector on the island. Then all you have to do is swim out to the island and turn the big reflector onto the robot. I'll stay here and protect the babes.
But I can't swim.
If you hit one of the connect all the when the light is.
Sometimes pushing a simple button is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push.
Birthday.
Children's balloons have been overfilled. They're carrying the children out of control.
I don't know, Mrs. Puff. It looks like they're having a lot of fun.
Yes, too much fun, if you ask me. You can save the children by bubble bashing each of the balloons. Bubble bash all the balloons, then come see me for a reward.
Can do, Mrs. Puff.
Ah!
me get ice cream now.
The children. Here's a golden spatula as a reward.
SpongeBob, I heard that you were collecting golden spatulas.
Yes, Bubble Buddy, I am. Have you seen one?
Why, yes. We were having a sandcastle contest, and somebody put a golden spatula on the top.
If I had a castle, I'd name it Fort Pattytown III, and Fort Pattytown III would have a big bake sale every Monday.
The golden spatula?
Oh, at the top of the sandcastle, right. That should be easy to reach.
Well, perhaps you should see for yourself.
pushing a simple button is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push. Water rising. Must get to higher ground. Just met the Sponginator. What's new?
Meow.
You don't say. Squidward bought a new sweater. Oh, he's so crazy.
Meow.
And there's a golden spatula at the end of this cave. Wow.
Thank you.
Sorry, lad, but the carnival is closed. A pesky robot has taken over me ticket booth, and worse, me money. If you help me get rid of that no-good robot, I'll give you a big reward. Not exactly what I had in mind. I hope my insurance covers all this. Why don't you try something less expensive? I mean, dangerous. I need them crazy robots cleared out of the bumper boats. When you've destroyed them all, come back and see me.
Ouch! Where's the whistle?
Reward.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy!
Try not to destroy any more of the pier, will you?
Oh!
Congratulations, SpongeBob! You're king of the beach! Here, have a golden spatula!
SpongeBob, you...
Now they're back!
Here's the golden back scratcher.
Spatula.
I don't speak Italian. What? No. Here's the...
Spatula.
I don't...
So, that's quality craftsmanship, that is. Come again.
Here to face a great challenge.
I've got nerves of steel and muscles of sand.
And eyes of jelly.
My Poseidome has been breached by a mighty foe whom you must vanquish.
Bring it on, Your Highness. Bring it on.
In this corner, defending the Poseidome, a small square guy. Murderous robot shaped like a squirrel.
Look, it's a giraffe.
I think I need to get home to feed Gary.
Looks like the robot's left itself vulnerable. Great Barrier Reef! Taking a beating out there. The robot better change tactics and...
I wanna play!
Patrick, we're not playing! We're fighting for our lives!
I wanna play!
Fast! Spling! The old clothesline move!
Much better.
Oh,
rearing its head. What a shocking takedown by Patrick!
A battle. Tell him what he's won, Johnny.
It's a new power, the Bubble Bowl. But wait, there's more. A golden spatula. And that's not all. A gift certificate for $5.32 to Dean's little shop of dried fish flakes and flowers.
Oh, thank you. It all means so much. I promised myself I wouldn't cry.
Cry all you want, but not here. Just wax the floors.
Hey, Plankton!
Yes, what is it?
I was just wondering why all the robots seem to be coming from inside the chum bucket.
Have they? I really haven't noticed.
Yeah. And then there's that big flashing neon sign that says, Robot Headquarters.
SpongeBob, I'm your friend, right?
No, not really.
Exactly, and as your non-friend, I worry about you. Like right now, you're thinking too much. I'm worried you might really hurt yourself. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna think for you. This way you won't hurt yourself, and you can just keep working on getting me into the chum bucket.
Thanks, Plankton. You're the best non-friend a friend could have. No more thinking for me. Not thinking, not thinking, not thinking.
Hurry up, I've got big plans to proceed with.